ready? Everyone's ready? Good? Good?
All right, let's rip.
Well, I just want to thank everyone for being here today. I want to thank the Teach Good Growing Town for 16 and all the members for standing behind me on this day. I am Rafael Espinal, the Chair of the Consumer Affairs Committee of the City Council, and I'm standing here today because I would like to announce that I would not be supporting a ban on the horse carriage industry. For over 100... For over 150 years, the horse carriage industry has grown to employ 300 drivers, blacksmiths, and stable workers, which contribute over $15 million in tourism dollars to New York City. They provide 380,000 rides per year, not only to our city's residents, but to people who come visit us from around the world. There are currently 4 horse stables located on the west side of Manhattan. All of the stables have been modified to provide oversized box stalls, and they have been modernized with state-of-the-art, top-of-the-line equipment to make sure that each horse is healthy and safe. In addition, all of the stables provide world-renowned veterinary care, and each horse receives two physicals per year. They also receive a 5-week vacation to a farm upstate where they get some time to relax in the sun, run in the pastures, and even have some nice ice cold water. Every horse has restricted working hours. They're not allowed to work more than 9 hours in any 24-hour given period. And they're not allowed to work for more than 2 hours without a break. These horses are protected from extreme weather conditions and are not allowed to be out in 90 degree or above weather, or weather under 18 degrees. The industry as a whole is regulated by 4 city agencies, including the Department of Consumer Affairs. To date, the carriages have made 6 million trips in traffic in the past 3 decades, in 30 years, with 0 human fatalities and only 3 equine deaths. Think about that. You have more of a chance of being in a plane accident than a horse being in an accident in our city streets. The industry as a whole is regulated by, with this being said, the plan to remove the horse carriages and end a 150-year tradition, which has now become a historical part of our city, an attraction, and part of our city's fabric, while taking away the jobs of 300 workers and destroying the city's income of $15 million in tourism dollars, not something that I can't support. This industry provides a very unique and diverse workforce. Most of the carriage drivers have immigrated to the United States from Italy, from Ireland, from China, from parts of Africa. These are immigrant workers who come here, and some of them are second generation because these are the trades they can work for our city. Workers are trained in safety, are very rigorously regulated by the city, and are required to have a New York State driver's license. So what will these 300 workers do if we propose a ban on them? There have been discussions of creating a job training program. But let's be real. In this market, it's going to be impossible to find 300 people a job as soon as they lose their job as horse carriage workers. And it's not a risk I am willing to take. Being the chair of the Consumer Affairs Committee, as well as being a city councilman, it is my duty and it's important for me to stand up for the working residents of New York City and to stand up for the world, the iconic attractions that New York City has to offer and make it a beautiful place for us to live. So I'm standing here to urge all of my colleagues who are undecided to stand behind me and protect the workers of our city at a time that we need jobs, at a time that we need to make sure that our unemployment rate does not increase. We need your support to support the Teamsters. Thank you.